Hi, John here again. I just ran out of film and we're back on again. We are left off that to Shannon Withers, my barrister. The time now is 8:38 p.m. Sunday, the 10th of July 2016, for the record. Please put this on record, Shannon Withers, the extension of the first video on this day, as proof of claim that we have authority to administer our title, land seizure warrants on Cook Street, 77 Cook Street, and Waitangi Marae Treaty Grounds and Te Tiri Marae land blocks, the TB3 land blocks, and all that area that Chief King Itaura wants back in his control and title through the British government, land laws of England, titles. Okay, so we are taking our land back this way, under this flag authority from that Marae King's Bench Court, Waitangi Marae King's Bench Court. Shannon Withers, can you put this on the record with Judge Collins, or the judge that's doing my court case, out of court? I request that you do my court hearing on Natalie Flower Dew Brown, CIB detective of Auckland Central Police Station, that she should have been subpoenaed back into the court, because that was my last court hearing. That was way back in January. Till now it's taken that long for you to settle this account that now liables Detective Natalie Flower Dew Brown for committing fraud and corruption on the Crimes Act 1961, New Zealand Crimes Act 1961, against me as authority to do what I'm doing, seize the lands. Okay, so I'm acting surrogate King William the Fourth, creditor and sheriff of that Marae in Waitangi. Authority direct to Britain, UK government and parliament, and the new Britain government and prime minister coming up. We have a contract, as you know, Shannon, with the British military to come here and operate their protection on this flag. The black part of this flag, the black line around the red cross, is the British military contract with us. And the red cross is the contract of Westminster to protect our financial investment banking interests of commerce and laws of the sea against John Key and Pope Francis, Queen Elizabeth II, and Rothschild Banks' threat against our national security and country and our chiefs, the landowners of this country. Now, Shannon, I'm making statements here as affidavits that on this video, I make this affidavit against the Pope. I just finished making the other video and swearing my oath of office on this video, because it cut out, and I'm carrying on continuing with this video on this day, as I, John Kahaki Wānoa, customary legal advocate, sheriff and surrogate King William the Fourth, title holder of Auckland, New Zealand, swear my oath of office to Almighty God, and I swear my oath of office to my Māori Earth God Tahitian Memorial statue standing in London, Queen Elizabeth Great Court Museum, as my title there, standing in Auckland, New Zealand, and Dunedin, New Zealand, with a crown on his head, a hat on his head in Dunedin, as the crown, Maui crown, earth god, sovereign, monarch to East Island, Tahiti, Pacific Islands title, and to the title here in Aotearoa New Zealand, native title, I swear my oath of office to Maui statue, standing in Brussels, standing in France, Belgium, Singapore, Washington DC, New York, and other countries of power that belongs to us, the native. I swear my oath of office to King Solomon and William the Conqueror and his descendants, King William the Third, and to King George the Third, the father of King Ernest Augustus the First, the father of King George the Fourth, the father of King William the Fourth, I swear my oath of office to those kings, the Emperor, King William the Fourth, and the flag that he gave us. Shannon, for the record, I'm swearing my oath of office to this commercial trading bank of free passage through the world, flag, sovereign authority, jurisdiction, 1835, constitution, 1835, and sovereignty, 1835, of our own self-government, declaration of independence, and also a declaration of war flag. We're in a state of emergency at the moment with Obama out of control. Shannon, is the reason why our country is at stake with John Key a threat on our national security, our country, and our citizens who are under our chief's flag authority that brought them here in the first place. They immigrated under this Admiralty Law of the Sea, banking, pound note, Bank of England Act legacy that belongs to us. So I'm saying, I swear my oath of office to all the entity that we use inside this flag, our authority to use it to protect our country and its natural resources from a threat of outside private corporation interests that John Key is administering on these lands that we found repugnant to our laws, the land laws of England, and also the native land laws of the Pacific Islands. Chiefs and the indigenous people of the world, we represent with this flag in 250 countries, Shannon, for the record, that I want you to settle the account between me and Natalie Flower Dew Brown, CRB detective, out of court. Settle it, and I'm instructing you to do that job with my authority that I'm explaining is the landlord of those lands and the owner, one of the owners, expressing my full capacity title holder authority with a mandate from Waitangi Marae, King's Bench Court, and the Chiefs, to back that up, and also the way Britain is with Brexit, adding to that weight of evidence in my favour. So, Shannon, I'm instructing you to kindly ask the judge, Collins, for a writ, right now, as of now, to seize 77th Cook Street land and its properties from James Pierce Brown and Simon Brett Browntree, who broke the law with their conveyancing lawyers, now liable with a bounty of £1 trillion on their head outside of that court. This is our private business that I did not need to disclose to anyone but me and the British military and the British government, pardon, and my chiefs. So I'm making this public notice that I don't wish the court to recover any account from Natalie Flower Dew Brown or any other police, Tim Duthie and Aaron Pascoe, as the other two detectives that I'm taking to court in England, in the High Court of Admiralty in England, and everyone else that's got a £1 trillion note on their heads is in either the High Court of Admiralty in London or the Waitangi Marae King's Bench Court. Has the same power as the High Court of Admiralty in London and the Westminster Government. The same power is inside that Marae, and its authority to those kings I just said, the emperors of Britain, UK. We have the case to wind up, because it's been a long time, Sharon, that this case has been dragging on, and I'm still waiting for you to clear it up. The Pope, on the other hand, watching this video and the other one I made, liables him to this same fraud with John Key and his TPPA, and all his corporate organisations, companies, are liable singly persons, and their companies are singly persons with their corporate names and trusts. So every trust and corporation in the world is now liable before and after the 16th of July 2016, when the Pope enforces his new world order laws on whoever he wishes, but not the British UK government, the British military, and the Commonwealth countries of the world under this flag of jurisdiction from Waitangi Marae, King's Bench Court, and our chiefs, natives, and every other native in the world who comes under this flag of Admiralty, as we pick those 250 countries I've listed. All those countries are inside this title now, as of now, and when I first put it out on our website, moaipowerhouse.com, is moaipowerhouse.com. moaipowerhouse.com is where the 250 countries' flags are flying with this flag. You are the recipient creditors of what we recover from the 970 million trillion pound notes. Shannon, the British military shall pay themselves from their account the Moai King William Trust, Moai King William the Fourth Trust account, pays the British military to recover all debts owed to the King's Bench Court, Waitangi Marae, King's Bench Court, and District Courts of New Zealand and Pacific Islands and the Commonwealth countries of the world under this flag. That's an order from me and my chiefs here on this video. So, I swear my oath of office to those kings, I swear my oath of office to British military and Westminster government, the new British government that consists of Wales and England and Aotearoa New Zealand and Pacific Islands. That's a three-state government to fill the void of Ireland gone and Scotland gone. And they've made that quite clear, that they wished to leave Britain. It's all ours. to jump into the void and fill the space that's left vacant by the Queen. The Queen is fraudulent in her dealings with everything that has the Queen on the courts above the judge's head. Shannon, I find offensive and repugnant to my chiefs. I want to make it clear, plain and clear to the judge to do this case amicably and settle so that we can restart in the same courthouse in a King's Bench court capacity. I have no objections to making a settlement with the police to clear the matter up on this video that I've sworn already. My duty of care to the people of New Zealand and the world for that matter, affected by what I say online in front of everyone, that it's my word against your word. Anyone who wishes to put an affidavit in front of me or you, Shannon Withers, to challenge what I'm saying. I'm saying I am God's truth, Maui truth, law, L-O-R-E, and I am King William's the Fourth Law, L-A-W, man's law, on pieces of paper. One spirit, Maui God, and one man's law, which is commerce, this law, prevails inside the Westminster Court and Parliament. Okay, so that's what I'm making quite clear on this video today, Sunday, that prior to Pope Francis passing his acts of the New World Order and FEMA camps and everything evil on the world on the 16th of July 2016, he's well advertised what he wants to do is kill everybody, poison everybody and strangle them in his oath of the Jesuits' oath, which is what they intend doing and are doing with Obama gone wild and Hillary Clinton gone wild and mad in their behavior of wrecking America, really wrecking America, and it's King George III's America that they're wrecking, and this flag, they are wrecking this flag, Shannon, and that's offensive. They are wrecking King William, King William's fourth flag, and his father, King George III's title in America, Canada, Australia, New Zealand, Africa, India, East India, all of those titles, they are wrecking. The church and state is wrecking. The Rothschilds is wrecking. The Queen is wrecking. The Queen is giving over the King's titles for the Rothschilds and the Pope to wreck the world and wreck its wealth off the common people of the world, the King's people, common people of the world, Shannon. So I want you to do due diligence and act responsibility or act responsible as a barrister in law that the police who I accuse have broken the New Zealand Crimes Act 1961 professionally, broke it, deliberately broke it and abused their power beyond that acceptable to the British government and to New Zealand government, Parliament. So, Shannon, this one was for you. This video was for you. I'm waiting for you to call me on Monday. I will call you if you don't call before midday. I will call you after lunch to find where you are at with my case, because there are a big audience of people watching, and me and my secretary should be in Westminster. We should have been there by now, because the British people are now confused and upset with what's happening in America, what's happening in the world, what's happening in Saudi Arabia and in Syria and all over that has been wrecked by these people. I'm accusing the Pope and his church and the Queen and her church, and now the Pope's made Islam wreck the Christian people and all those other people, including the Catholic Church people in America, by saying it's offensive to have a cross or anything with Jesus on it. Yet I find that offensive, even though I'm not one of those religious people. I'm a Maori person, straight to the universe and to the ground and the earth, and not that Western culture. We have our own beliefs in nature and the preservation of land and people, living matter, and not what I'm seeing with poisoning food, poisoning the skies, the food, poisoning the trees and the fish, and wrecking the skies and shaking the earth and cracking open to get oil and minerals out of this earth. So those are all politicians and church and state that we're building these crimes against them. Shannon? So please keep me from waiting, and my administrators, my chiefs up in Waitangi, that gives me all this power to exercise our right to protect our native lands as should be. We are holding to account who uses it in the wrong way we don't approve of. We're not talking with iwi Māori, because that is your crown ownership, brand name and titles. Ours is Māori crown, British titles to these country lands, and you are separate from our titles. Okay? So I'm just making that clear. We don't want money from land back. We just want our land back. Not, we'll deal with it in recovering debts in our court in Waitangi Marae. That is our private business. With this flag is private business. Contracts. Okay, that's born out of this flag, Shannon. And the government legislated it out. We're already legislated back in the Marae itself, in Waitangi. So I want to make that quite clear. I want to make this video quite clear that the chiefs and I, on the 15th of March 2016, open Waitangi Marae on the treaty grounds for business. We opened it up for business. And the police constable there, Tipene, I think it is, he was there to witness what transpired that day, 5 o'clock in the morning, with Māori, the caretaker of the Marae, welcoming us there with our delegation and our chief, Kingi Tauru. Now, I want to say this to you. Chief Kingi Tauru is a descendant, a direct blood descendant of King Edward and Queen Victoria. So he has the right title and the right authority to have me as his legal advocate to seize his land back into his ownership and his marae and a ship from Britain. Now that Brexit is back, it's our Britain. It's not the EU's Britain anymore. John Key went a bit too far with his unauthorized authority to go ahead and sell these lands off with the Governor General to TPPA and to elect themselves, nominate themselves, or appoint themselves to positions outside this flag of jurisdiction from the Hapu chiefs, not the iwi. The Hapu chiefs is a king's bench court, and the iwi Māori is a queen's bench court. Just to make the distinction clear on this video, Shannon, that my chiefs are watching The British are watching. The British military is watching. And the British Parliament and government is watching what I say to them and to the rest of the big nations watching. America, Canada, Australia, New Zealand, India, Africa, Saudi Arabia, and so forth, are watching what you do and what the judge does on these lands the Queen says she owns. I'm just saying, no, she don't. The King owns the lands with this flag that's still legal. It's still legal. It has been lying there waiting for us to pick it up and use it. We have opened its business in the right marae where John Key and the president of the private company Waitangi National Trust are operating their business of admiralty against what the chiefs don't get disclosed to know about. I've assessed the situation, Shannon, as a native assessor of these lands to protect our native lands from exploitation or defrauding or corrupting. It is my job to be accountable for what goes on these lands that are not given approval from the chiefs. Not your chiefs, not your iwi authorities chiefs, not your Waitangi Tribunal, not your Māori FOMA, Federation of Māori Authorities, that is your entity, not your corporations or trust, but our King's Bench Court chiefs, hapū, native assessors. We are the landowners because that's what we're saying to you on this video, that I'm operating a native business straight to Britain as the chiefs of these lands. The landlord, landowner, legitimate landowner of these lands, John Key, and you, Jerry Matipurai. I'm saying this publicly, internationally, that I am going to Westminster as the representative of this country, the ambassador of New Zealand, to represent our native country and its flag. And you can so join it or stay as a debtor or creditor. Take your choice. People watching in this country, do not argue, because we'll go straight into court to see who you are. That's the first thing I'll ask. Who are you? How did you get here? Where's your title? Where's your oath of office? Where's your jurisdiction? Where's your constitution? Where's your sovereignty? And where's your title? That's what I'll ask. That's what I'll ask. And that's what native assessors are there for. They ask those questions. How did you get here? Okay? That's what I'm saying, Shannon. You being from America, in the federal law there, we are federal. This is a federal flag. This is a federal flag, the only federal flag in the world that is legitimate to Britain, UK, Westminster Parliament. This is the only King's flag in the world. This is the only bank trading commercial flag in the world. This is the only British military protectorate flag in the world. This is the only indigenous native chiefs sovereignty of their own self-government flag in the world. This is the only bank flag in the world. This is the only pound note legitimate currency flag in the world. All of that lot and more. It is a levy debtor instrument flag that can confiscate anything in the world that has been derived of its wealth and property rights and law from Westminster Parliament. Okay? We are in Westminster Parliament as I speak, because they are our partner to business. We haven't even started yet since the old days, because this government legislated it out. We legislated it back in, Shannon, in that marae. That's our property in there. That's our carvings in there. It looks like a marae. It is a marae. It is one of ours on our land. Argue that in court and see if you've got something better than what's on Facebook. 68 sites on Facebook, Shannon, and 905 videos to back up what I'm saying. If that's not enough, the judge is going to say the same thing, what he said to me and you, when you asked them the question. Oh, John wants to ask you a question. Judge Collins says, there's no need. It's all on YouTube. Rest my case. That's an affidavit for you. And the video was the best way to put what I want to say across instead of a million words and pictures. Okay? It was better to say it out so everyone can hear what I'm saying to you. So please adhere to my instructions. What I say as a person with enough authority and precision to do this job on these lands to protect our interests and those people who are not happy with the current situation of politics. I'm in the political field as well as the title field and as well as the economic development field of policy in country foreign currency policies here on our land. I am proficient in all of that to represent this country as it should be. People's rights to life and the resources, and not controlled by someone else that not here. The people here will suggest otherwise. Who controls? We are supporting, Shannon, we are supporting the new Prime Minister in Britain to be Andrea, a woman, in Brexit to be the new Prime Minister. Watching this video, we support you from here to trade with us direct. And I see, make note of this on the record, Shannon, please, that John Key has gone and made tentative contracts to Britain while David Cameron is still Prime Minister. He has abused the position of a weak Britain in limbo of its authority to govern its country, and he's gone in at a vulnerable time to make trade deals for his own personal gain when he's in the EU Parliament trying to shut down Westminster. He's trying to shut it down. Now he's running there to make deals as if it's all right to just bolt in there and put something on the table for New Zealand. That's not a very good image of New Zealand making back deals without the chiefs, the landowners of this country. He's putting the whole country profile as being arrogant and ignorant of the native chiefs. At Waitangi, he's been arrogant to sign the TPPA trade agreement without our consent or without any consideration of the interests of New Zealanders and citizens here, and especially the chiefs of the Hapu natives. And so Kingi Tauroa chief barred him from going on to the marae, Titi marae. When he can't get onto that marae, he can't get consent to come on that land anymore. That prevails. Shannon, for the record, that prevails of what Kingy says and bars him from the land, bars him from going on to any piece of land that belongs to Ngāpuhi. All of that land belongs to Ngāpuhi and the flag. This is their flag. They're the ones that put the contract together, nobody else. Tainui have their own flag, and so does other tribes, hapu, have the right to their own autonomy as it was given under this flag to self-govern. We are expressing our own individual rights to govern ourselves. Shannon? And I have the rights to do that, to self-govern this country and sack John Key and his government right off if I want to. Right? That's what Sue Nakora wants to do. She has a mandate from Russia and from the United Nations to go to the United Nations and represent the Maori government. That's sitting in the waiting. I got all that here, Shannon. I've got all those documents here for that government and the Confederation of Chiefs under this flag. I'm in this Confederation as one of the chiefs, one of them, that administers that native side of land here. We might not have titles like you, but we do certainly have British titles that we can apply over and above these titles of John Key's, paper titles. Okay, we can go right over those titles with British land titles anytime soon. So I don't want to push that too far. I just want my land back on Cook Street to put the records straight between me and the Crown Government. Nothing against anybody, but I'm following the law of New Zealand to a T to make sure who broke it. And I'm accusing Natalie Flower Dew Brown of breaking New Zealand law. I don't have to say it again, I've already said it before in the other videos. So I'm saying on this video that today I made statements against the Pope. I will make another video against the Queen, and I'll make another video against the Rothschild banks to bankrupt them. The pound note will bankrupt them all with this flag if British government says so. If they became that much of a threat, we will bankrupt them with our orders as the other partner to them. They need us in this flag, and we need them and their military. We need the British military to come here and look after the Pacific Ocean and its resources from being tampered with our contract. All right, Shannon, you know that word, tampering? Tampering with contracts in America is a severe penalty for that. The consequences of tampering with someone's private defaulted contract on Cook Street is a major offence that pulls in everyone who got in my road, especially the police and their lawyers got in the road and broke the law with the landowners. With the first landowner, Doug Rickard Bell, he's already been convicted in the courts, in our courts, in Waitangi Marae. He's going to lose what he's got, and everyone following that. Everyone that's linked in Joinder as accessories to help them to defraud the public of New Zealand. They not only defraud us, Shannon, they defraud the taxpayer. The tax havens, the Panama tax havens that John Key has allowed to occur here on these lands, our native lands, and end up in the fraud themselves, with the foreign countries, business people here channeling money through here as tax havens, is going to be investigated. I want you to start proceedings to investigate the Panama tax havens here and John Key's accounts. I want him arrested. I want Jerry Mataparai arrested for conspiracy to defraud the chiefs of this land and the public with the Queen. I want them arrested, and Obama arrested, and Hillary Clinton arrested. It's looking, certainly looks that way now, that they are really really up to their necks in fraud and corruption coming out in the public eye, and also John Key is looking more shakier every day, and the amount of expense that he's put this country into debt more and more is mounting up as normal for him to run a scam business. Not unlike Donald Trump, that's running our business, and being a politician as a businessman is a big far cry from politicians who don't know anything about law. The same with Natalie Flowerdew Brown. She's not a lawyer to have forged those documents, and you know very well, Shannon, that she has forged those documents that have been used to extract money out of me and my image name, John Wanoa, in capitals. Alright? You know the story about that. Well, I'm saying that's just one of the offences that I have labelled against her, and the whole establishment is doing the same thing. Everyone is doing it, Shannon. So I just want to end all their lot and take that land and go in there. I want to go in there as soon as possible because I've got a lot of development lands down the East Coast, 30 of them land blocks, to develop straight off. Straight from that one, it'll kick into life and you will be well placed to represent me in Britain and travel there with me and secure the pathway through and the legal avenues set up. That's what I'm offering you to do on this video in front of everybody watching, because it's gone a bit too far now with the amount of information I'm putting out that the judge cannot, for the life of me, use any of it against me, let alone anyone else who's got information to back up against it. It's just overwhelming to have anyone try to rebut it. Okay, so that's all I want to say in this video. Unfortunately, the other video went for the whole 3 gigabytes, and it cuts off when that happens, so my videos are getting longer and longer, but I hope they are bringing more information to those people who are watching around the world how I'm performing, and I see some comments that are really humbling with me and my little team, Desmond Wano and Jamie, Anna Marie, Patrick Stewart, and she's hoping that we can get going because she's got a lot of time and effort behind what we do here, and thank you for that help and just being there at the right time online, and also Desmond, he's got a big job to look after the land block at the East Coast, and also my son, he's just come on today and let me know how things are, which is good, and that they take interest in what I do, the same as Jamie's family takes interest in what she does, as well as Desmond. I'm not forgetting the other people who have helped along the way, to give them the support when we get going, to pull them back into everything. And all those people who are waiting for shares, we're getting the base ground set firmly in place so that it won't break down halfway along, or anything legally is going to interfere after this has been settled with Cook Street. We're seizing the property as a consequence of breaking the law of these lands, and breaking New Zealand law in particular, and their jurisdiction and our jurisdiction as the landlords of these properties. And unfortunately for them, they've abused the law against us, and the police were no help either to assist them to do that and try to break more laws. By doing so, has landed them in court. Okay? I had to go to court to pull the fraud out of it and show it up as being a victim when I'm not a victim. I'm a king surrogate to speak for the land and for the chiefs and for the king himself in his absence until we get King Ernest Augustus into Westminster. I'm saying to the government in Britain, the best and quickest way to get Britain flying around the world back into trade is this flag. I'm appealing to you to give us a call. I thought that Nigel Farage would have called me or at least left a message on my Facebook or Twitter or Google or YouTube and talk business as partners. But unfortunately, he answered John Key and looked at what he was offering Britain as free trade deal. I find that quite odd that he hasn't recognised us and who we are with this much power in a flag and the pound note, wrapped up in the pound note, that would make Britain great again in one fell swoop. So, Shannon, it's been a long video, but I just want to make it clear to you and to Balkan Chambers that this is a long time for me to wait, since the 3rd of October 2015, right till now, to get an answer of a case that should have been tied up in no time. There's no complications in it, it's just there. It's just their word against mine, or anyone's word against mine, and any iwi, Maori, in Ngāti Whātua who's got a problem with that, they need to put it in writing or stack up an affidavit against me. It's not going to happen. I've already been through that with the Manukau title, and they wouldn't talk. No one wants to talk when you're holding the titles. And so that's the Crown's entity. The Crown made all those decisions with Ngāti Whātua. But when it comes to the real titles, that's where they have a problem, even with One Tree Hill, with Kawhiri the Giant up there, the memorial made into a footpath. That was Ngāti Whātua. Iwi. Iwi. The iwi is Crown property. Iwi belongs to Crown Corporations and Queen. They get the bill, Shannon. The iwi leaders and their authorities gets the bill. The figure goes on, and if King says that's the figure, that's the figure. He's agreeing with the figures I'm saying. He's agreeing with the pound note. Even though he's King Edward, he still has a claim to Queen Victoria's title and King Edward's title, even though we've got a claim to King William. Those are kings we're talking about. He's talking king, I'm talking king. We are the king's people, authority, in this whole business. So, Kingy, to you, I'm just doing my job, mate, and making sure we get our facts right. We get our information to the barrister, and if he's so good to do it, then he's our man. You're our man, Shannon. And that's all I ask of you. Anyway, that's all I want to say to you. I'll just address my audience and people who are curious to know what's next on the agenda. I say to the corporations, Maori incorporations, and anybody in the Confederation, there's several different Confederation members, all doing their own thing. I'm just warning you that all those documents that have got the Queen on it and any indication of Crown of John Key's government or anything else of the Pope's laws, the UCC law, the canon law, courier law, civil law, admiralty law, it's no longer going to be usable after the 16th of July 2016. You can use it, but when it goes to a court where I'm in the court in the district court, you don't go to the high court, you go to the district court, they can just shove it aside and play around with it as if they're going to use it. They can use it because there's no other law around. They'll use that law illegally or legally. They'll still use that Pope's law even though he's destroyed it. But my argument is, if anybody uses it in front of me, they're going to get stung with the British law, right? The 1838 and 37 law of King William IV. No one's doing that. No one's talking for the King. They're only flying the flag around, but they don't know how it works, let alone the bank works. So be careful, all you Maoris, because the word Maori belongs to John Key. So if you write things Maori, iwi, or documents that got Maori word on it, you're in trouble. With this one and the King, you're in trouble. Because you can't change over one entity under the Queen's head to the King's head just like that. No, you've got to go through Waitangi Marae before you can get to this one. Alright, I'm just saying. The argument here is anybody pushing their laws, in even in corporations or anyone with fancy writing that I don't like, I get offended by anybody using those laws, you're going to find yourself holding on to something that's not worth the paper it's written on. There's too many words for a start. There's too many laws for a start. When you look at the 1830 to 1837 King William laws, there's not many. There's not a hell of a lot. You can just about read the front and the back end of it. That's what I'm saying. I'm going to use those laws because no one can touch it. It's private. When you learn private law of contracts, this is nobody's business. That's what I'm saying to Shannon. It's no one's business between me and those landowners on that block. It's between what they say to me and me to say to them. When they go to the barrister talks for them, like my barrister talks for me. And I tell him what to do. They tell their barrister or lawyer what to say, and that lawyer will do what they say, even if it's right or wrong. I'm saying, in this law, they're wrong, right? And it's up to them to say, I'm wrong. Well, they're not saying anything. When you say nothing to accusations in public, it becomes law. If the barrister goes and sees them and says, look, you haven't challenged them. That's it. He goes to the court, makes an order over the counter, pays it, and then the court decides. In the absence of a reply or response, you lose. That's what I'm waiting for. I'm waiting for someone to make a move. No one's prepared to make a move with this much weight behind it. And chiefs. And the Marae, that's the highest court in the world, with this flag flying on it and the British flag flying on the land that belongs to the chief. Not all the other chiefs. It's his piece of land that he can dig a hole in and not offend anyone, right? He can put a hangi pit there and cook on it. Well, he won't do it because he'd be embarrassed with his mate, Jerry Mataparai, his trench mate in the Vietnam War, said to him, oh, I want to be a Governor General. And Kingi says, I want to be a chief. And so that's how it came out. And I say, I want to be a